some mute fruits for seeding, and there'll be caps for your pocket. Off you go, then.
Welcome to Grey Garden, darling. This is the Commonwealth's first and only hydroponics facility, run entirely by robots.
This place seems familiar. I think I saw a bit about it on the news back before the war.
It is hard to imagine how this has survived for so long.
Yes, construction was completed mere days before the war. We were able to survive and continue our operations only because our creator made us fully self-sufficient. You see, there are two kinds of robots here. The worker drones carry out labor and maintenance. We supervisors, that is myself, green and brown, possess sophisticated cognition processors. We are capable of complex analysis and decision-making. A testament to the genius of our creator, Dr. Edward Gray.
I remember him. He was one of Rodko's senior engineers, but more than a little eccentric.
That's the second time you've said that you remember something before the war. I think you're a little confused, darling. You simply can't have been alive back then. Robotics and artificial intelligence were our creator's great passions, rivaled only by his love of television. Perhaps you've noticed that I possess a rather singular personality, as do the other supervisors.
This took a weird turn.
Well, it's definitely unique. Sort of hard to miss.
I'll take that as a compliment, darling. After all, the last thing any woman wants to be is ordinary. A few other things you should know. Talk to Green if you need supplies. If it's caps you require, Brown might have a few odd jobs. There's one other thing. A question, really. Tell me, darling, what do you think of the water around here?
It's awful.
Isn't it, though? Pressure is down, radiation is up. Why, it's practically toxic. Just think what it must be doing to my skin. This will never do. I don't mean to impose, darling, but perhaps you could lend us a hand.
What do you need me to do?
Most of our water comes from the old Western plant, south of here. Such an eyesore. Be a dear and pay a visit, See what you can do. Maybe tidy up the place. It must be filthy. If you can get it working again, I'm sure I can come up with something for you.
Caps for meat. That's the way.
Trading's the game. Ready to bargain in the garden?
You sound like a game show host.
That's the correct answer. Well done. Ladies and gentlemen, should we tell the lucky contestant what fabulous prize she's won?
Okay. Show me what I've won.
Right this way, please. Let's take a look at your fabulous prize. It's a brand new car! Wow! Now, if you've already got the latest in sleek, stylish, atomic-powered automation, you can also take your winnings in the form of a cash prize! How does 100 caps sound?
I've got an idea. Let's make a deal!
I like it! How about 150 caps?
Ah, tempting, but can you do a little better?
Whoa! You're really looking to push your luck, aren't you? All right, 200 caps it is. I should warn you, asking for more could lead to disqualification. So you might want to stop right there.
Oh, come on. A new car's worth more than that.
Oh, I'm sorry, but you've pushed your luck just a bit too far. I'm afraid 100 caps is all I can offer. Here you go! Well, it's been a real pleasure. Thanks for playing!
Thank you.
to say it, but it's too quiet.
White.
Darling, so good to see you. It's not what?
That's right.
That's marvelous, darling. Simply marvelous. Here, you can have some of our produce. I'll ask Greenie to give you a discount, too, if there's anything else you need. Now I simply must get back to work. Ta-ta!
What's up?
What is it?
What now?
We've gotten big enough that we're having trouble communicating with all our settlements. It's a good problem to have, and I have a solution. I think it's time to retake the castle. It used to be the Minutemen HQ, way before my time. Well fortified, centrally located, and most important, it has a powerful radio transmitter we can use to broadcast to the whole Commonwealth.
So what happened to this castle if it was so well fortified?
This was long before I joined up, but the story I heard was that some kind of monster came out of the sea and destroyed the fort. A lot of the leaders were killed in that battle, and I guess nobody ever felt it was worth the risk to try to retake it. I've always wondered if losing the radio station was the beginning of all our later problems. So, should I have an assault force assemble near the castle?
Yeah, let's do this.
We'll do some recon and meet you outside the castle. See you there.
You think it's easy being this beautiful? I should be. It is not.
Absolutely.